Kung Fu Panda is a remarkable film. We're seeing things come to life on screen that, frankly, we've not been able to do before. It really is the combination of great action with the mystery of China, with fighting, kung fu, fur, and of course, a great story.
We wanted it to be a real big action movie as much as it was an intimate character story. Plus we have characters with fur and they wear clothing, and those are both very complicated, and in most movies you get to choose one of those two things.
Then when you ask somebody to jump 20 feet in the air and do a roundhouse kick, you know, wearing cloth and, you know, things get tricky.
So we were very ambitious, and everyone else who worked on the film was just as ambitious and worked really hard to figure out how they could contribute some, you know, creative solutions to some of these very complicated, complex artistic problems that we kept presenting them with every single day. But all the departments came together to really, you know, put their best work in, you know, from animation to effects to rigging to character effects.
We found very early on that the rigs, which sort of is the internal skeleton of the character, they wouldn't hold up to the physicality of kung fu. It was just too much strain and burden on the rigs, so we had to go back and totally re-engineer and redesign all the rigs for all the characters so they would actually be able to do martial arts.
This shot was one that really showed off what you guys were doing with the rig for Viper.
It's very important for Viper to be able to twist in ways that should be impossible, and also to have all the breaking points in her shape. It was important for all the kung fu to be visible and recognizable. Like here when she stretches to the left side, you know, it was important for us to actually give a hint of a kick.
And this was a great test for the technology, for the character design, for the rig that we put in there. And, you know, once we saw this, we kind of felt like we had a character that was going to fly.
Overall, I think the coolest thing that you achieved with the surfacing was you maintained the intent of the design. The idea to keep it believable was to actually make them almost more like plush toys. Teddy bears getting in kung fu fights, which I think is the great contrast in the film, that you've got this soft feel and then you've got the hard impact of kung fu.
We did short fur that wasn't dynamic. We didn't want all the fur to be bouncing every time their character bounced. So because of that, we also had to spend a lot of time grooming. We went messy, we went clean, and we ended up having to just put a lot of dense fur on there because it was so short and we needed it to be structured.
The other advantage of the short fur was we had to deal with clothing on a lot of our characters.
Yeah! Excellent.
We knew we had furry characters with clothing, and we had to figure out a way to use computing power to solve that, to make this movie possible.
Smoosh is our technology for fur to clothing contact. Smoosh allows us to slide the clothing over the surface and for the fur to actually move and be pushed down in the areas where it is, and then it springs up as the clothing releases it. Once we had that kind of look, we can then customize it in terms of how much the fur lays down, how fast it springs back, to really get that kind of naturalistic look.
An important part of this was automating it, because when you have 1,500 shots, several characters, maybe even crowds, that all use this technology, it needed to be something that we could use as an artistic tool, but also use it as a computing tool.
We wanted a system whereby a lot of the stuff would go through automatically so that we could really concentrate on the action moments.
Because we're a kung fu movie, we also had to push the effects in our film further than any movie the studio's ever done before.
One of the key examples was Tai Lung's escape, and we wanted to break the last big obstacle, kind of, which was the breaking of the bridge.
The first thing we're given is basically an artwork. From rough layout, we have a kind of a choreography of, in general, how things should work. So this is kind of the input that we give to the system, where we paint the different colors on the outside of the geometry, and the system takes that as input and spills out basically the final pieces. or your broken bridge. At the same time, we start adding the detail to add scale to the shots. The rocks that emit from the cracks as the big pieces crack apart, stuff that exploded from the ceiling that's falling down.
It's important for us to really sell the scale and make it believable. It's a marriage between really art direction and technology, which I think right. exemplifies to some extent how we approach movie making.
The ultimate showcase of all the technical work all our great departments did, rigging, character effects, special effects, clothing, everything. It was probably the rope bridge, probably the single most taxing and demanding and technically complex sequence in the whole film.
There wasn't a single department that was confident about, oh yes, I've done that before.
We had breakage, we had water, we had sort of just kung fu destruction, we had impacts on the characters, we had all sorts of crazy stuff that no other movie that DreamWorks has ever done, and it's one of the things we're most proud of in the movie. Because all we really want people to do is to be involved in the story of, the Furious Five fighting Tai Lung and get caught up in the fight, and hopefully all of that other stuff, even though it required thousands of man hours to get right, hopefully all of that just goes away and you just get lost in the story.
When you're making computer animation, technology is at the essence of what we do. And having the best tool set in the hands of great artists makes great movies. The ability to create richer and more compelling images is something that we look to do literally each and every time with each movie beyond what we've done before.
Today's technology are bringing to life films that we couldn't have even imagined a couple years ago. And it's exciting to think about where that's all heading for the future.